Hello, Sana. How are you?
Hello, sir. I'm fine.
Good.
Hello, students.
Hello, students. Now, today we are going to discuss a very important phenomenon in living organisms. That process is called as osmosis. Now, let us first define what is osmosis. Osmosis is a transfer of water molecules through a semi-permeable membrane from a region of low concentration of the solution to the portion of the side which is of a high concentration of the solution. Now, for example, let us take an example that in human body, if you put here in a salt solution, the salt is highly concentrated. The cell membrane of a human cell is a semi-permeable membrane, and inside, if there is a water, the water can come from inside the cell to the outside. Normally, if you take a resin, for example, or kishmish, and you dip it in water, the outer skin of this resin is a semi-permeable membrane, and inside it contains what? What is the taste of your resin?
It's sweet.
Sweet.
Sugar.
It contains sugar. So inside the concentration is very high of sugar. So that means it's a strong solution of sugar inside. Outside you have only water. So therefore now water should enter from area of weak solution to area of strong solution or stronger solution through this semi-permeable membrane. Okay. So now water will enter from outside into the resin. What is the result? More matter. So the resin will bulge.
Okay, we can say that it is from lower concentration to higher concentration.
It's a transfer
movement
of water,
of solvent.
Movement of solvent, that is water in this case,
yes,
from low concentration to high concentration through a semi-permeable membrane. Now take the same resin which is now bulged and put it in a very strong sodium chloride solution. What will happen? Outside more salt, inside no salt. So the water from inside the cell will come, or the resin will come outside through the same semi-permeable membrane. In both the cases, first when the resin bulged, water moved from outside into the resin. Now with the bulged resin, the water moved from inside the resin to salt solution side. Is it clear now?
Okay.
So it's only the movement of solvent
and
not the solutes. And this cell membrane, both in plants and animals, is a semi-permeable membrane. That is again a wonderful thing of nature that has created, and is very, very important to understand that. Now to demonstrate this process, we are going to take an example here that we are taking a raw egg. The egg is covered with a membrane which is a semi-permeable membrane. Now how to take this egg out? Now chemistry comes to our help, right? Now if you see the structure of the outer shell, it is calcium carbonate. What is it? Calcium carbonate. Now this calcium carbonate reacts with acids. So therefore we will just take this normal egg, raw egg, and then we'll take dilute hydrochloric acid and then put this dilute hydrochloric acid on this. What are you seeing?
Oh, I think, sir, the calcium carbonate is dissolving in acid.
Yes, you are seeing plenty of froth.
I can see,
Yes, you are seeing plenty of froth.
Yes.
And then you will find here that if you take a spatula and just rotate it here, you will find that a very vigorous reaction takes place, and this froth is the denaturation of the proteins. Now calcium carbonate does not give any froth, but what is happening here, lot of carbon dioxide is released here, and that carbon dioxide is being soluble in water but not as much, so therefore it bubbles out, and as it bubbles out here, this foam is again, as soon as the acid is entering inside the egg, the proteins of the egg are getting denatured, and therefore this denatured proteins are the one which are giving this froth. Right? Now, if you allow sufficient time for this egg to be immersed in this strong acid or weak hydrochloric acid, then the entire outer covering will be completely dissolved or it will react. What is formed? You got, you take a reaction, calcium carbonate, hydrochloric acid, what you should get? You must have calcium chloride plus water plus carbon dioxide. That bubbles are of carbon dioxide that you are seeing. And then, once you take this egg here, now I have taken in this small petri dish that an egg which has already immersed in hydrochloric acid for sufficient time, and now you can feel this egg, it is liquid from inside,
and it is not a boiled egg,
it is not a hard egg, it's not a boiled egg.
Yes.
That means the content of this egg are still in the liquid state, right? And then now what should be, all of you have opened eggs, how does it look? It has got white portion and a yellow portion, right? Now let us take a small nick on this. So you're seeing this here portion.
Yes.
I'm just holding it with my finger, taking this pair of scissors, and then taking a small nick on this. Now the egg is opened here, and then you'll find that a lot of liquid content can come out of this. You are seeing the white portion.
Yes.
You are seeing the yellow portion.
Yellow portion too.
Yeah,
yes.
The white portion is the albumin.
Yeah.
Right, and the yellow portion is the globulin. Right.
Yes.
And it also contains a lot of fats. Right. Now we are just emptying this egg of all its contents. Very, very carefully you have to maneuver.
So when we put an acid on a raw egg, the hard shell got dissolved.
Yes.
But we can see a thin layer over an egg. It didn't got dissolved.
Correct.
What is the reason, sir?
So it doesn't dissolve because the acid doesn't dissolve the protein. It only denatures it.
Okay.
So it becomes completely transparent, right? But now you'll find here the inner portion of the egg now is hardened now. That is because of denaturation of the proteins. I'll take this egg. I'm emptying it, a large portion. Now for a good experiment, you must take this very fresh, right? Then what happens? The proteins are not completely denatured. They're easily drained out. And it will be easy for us to do the experiment, but this also is good enough. So now I'll take this entire denatured proteins, take this tray, and maybe I'll wash this thoroughly so that all the inner content is drained out. Now we got a very nice bag of this semi-permeable membrane.
This bag is a semi-permeable membrane,
right?
Yes.
And then see, in an embryo which is still live, right, it also carries all the metabolism. It has to grow inside.
Yes.
And therefore it requires this communication or this barrier between external and internal. Now please see here, Sana.
Yes.
See the beautiful semi-permeable membrane, transparent, almost transparent.
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes.
And then this is a semi-permeable membrane. Right?
Okay,
you can almost see my finger through it. Right? You can see my finger through it. Right? It's so transparent. Right?
So this is a membrane through which solvent transfer of
the,
solvent,
yes,
movement
the,
of solvent, we
correct.
Can say movement of solvent takes place.
Correct. Now what we have to do here is now to prove this experiment, we have to create a situation where on one side of it you have a high concentration, and other side you should have a low concentration. So for that, what we are taking here, we are taking this thistle funnel and this, we are just opening this bag. Now it is very, very delicate. We have to handle it very carefully and gently slide this over here and pass this thistle funnel. Now we got it right. So we have semi-permeable membrane covering the opening of the thistle funnel. Now will you help me tying this nicely? So in this groove
I'll
here,
use a thread.
Yes, you
here.
Use a thread. You just wet the thread so that it doesn't cut into that. Now you can see the diaphragm of a semi-permeable membrane, right? Correct. Make a couple of turns. Make one more round off. So this is a thistle funnel, and to this end we have tied this semi-permeable membrane. Please see here, watch. Right here, it is acting like a diaphragm. Right? Look at it here. Right. Now in this beaker, we'll take some salt. Put some salt here.
Okay, I'm adding some amount.
Correct.
Little amount of salt.
No, not little. Make it concentrated.
Oh, very concentrated.
More the difference, better the osmosis.
Is it
very
enough?
Good, very good. Right. Now, just dissolve it. Very well, right? So let us dissolve this solution here to make a very concentrated solution.
This is a highly concentrated solution.
Yeah, it's highly concentrated sodium chloride, NaCl. Now can have a one dropper so that we can just gently put this, or we can get a syringe also if you have got. Now just put all this salt solution inside this. Okay. Now in this beaker we have got a very strong solution of sodium chloride. This I am taking with this syringe. Can you please hold it?
Okay.
So I'm going to take sufficient quantity of highly concentrated sodium chloride solution, and very gently I'm going to just inject it inside it. You can find here that this will be filled here.
Okay. okay, we are filling the semi-permeable membrane
on one side,
with,
yes,
okay, one side,
correct,
with a salt,
with a strong solution
strong
of salt.
Solution.
So are you able to see, Sana, gradually the,
yes,
now
sir.
The thistle funnel is getting filled. Please notice that not a drop of liquid is coming out from the other side.
Yes, sir.
Right?
There's no leakage over here.
There's no leakage. There's no leakage. That means what? That this is acting like completely impervious membrane. Normally, if you even take an ordinary tissue paper or any or piece of cloth, and if it is transparent, you will find that yes, the water will go through the other side.
Yes, sir.
But see the beauty.
So can we say
that
even in semi-permeable membrane, we are making a highly concentrated
No, we are
area.
Not. We are not. Now we are separate. We are using the semi-permeable membrane to create two sections.
Okay.
One section inside the semi-permeable membrane in the funnel is highly concentrated solution of sodium chloride.
Okay.
And then we will take another beaker. We'll just take plain water.
Okay.
Now, which side is weaker and which side is stronger?
In the semi-permeable membrane, it is the higher.
Correct, sir.
And outer, it is lower
in, yeah,
because we are taking a plain water, and
correct,
here we filled
correct.
With a highly
correct.
Concentrated
solution.
Salt solution.
So in the thistle funnel is high concentration.
High concentration.
Right. In the beaker outside is
low
concentration. Low
concentration.
Now I have taken here some water here, and you will find. Now can you get me one just beaker, large beaker, so that we can now
immerse
it.
We use the small one.
Yeah, okay. Good. Just put plain water here
okay.
inside this.
I'm filling this beaker with a plain water.
Plain water. Now I am going to immerse it inside this, and I want you to observe that the water level inside this stem will now rise. And this happens reasonably fast. It happens reasonably fast because now we have concentration difference is very, very high.
Okay,
now,
that means the water
correct.
From the beaker move inside the
correct.
Semi-permeable membrane.
Correct.
This is the reason why the water level increases in the
correct. So now you see, I just suspended this thistle funnel inside here, and you'll find that the water started rising.
Yes, sir.
Have you seen this rise of water here?
Yes, sir.
You can see it is above the water level.
Yes, sir.
Now let us keep it for some time and observe that the water level inside the stem will rise progressively.
So here we proved, sir, yes, osmosis is movement of solvent from
correct.
Lower concentration
now,
to higher concentration.
Now what is happening? Water inside the beaker is weak. The solution inside the thistle funnel is strong.
Strong.
Now water will move through semi-permeable membrane into the thistle funnel. Water is matter.
Yes.
It requires space. So therefore, it will have only one way to go. Go in an upward direction.
Yes.
Right? So this is very, very important. Now all of you have heard the word ORS or oral rehydration therapy. Right? Now what happens is you get electrolyte or something, you get it. Right? And people at randomly what they do, they just take one glass of water. Just put 2-3 spoons of this powder and then try to drink it or give it to the patient. That's a very incorrect way of making it. What you must do it, you must take the complete packet or a sachet of your electrolyte powder, take 1 liter of water and put the entire powder into this and make a solution which is of a known concentration. Because if you make this solution of high concentration and give it to the patient who is already suffering from diarrhea or loose motions, water from his body will come into his bowels and he will pass more loose motions. Right? Instead of helping the patient, you are harming the patient. Right? So what is important? That you must observe the conditions and given instructions very, very carefully. Right? This is important because osmosis is such an important process that if you do it wrongly, instead of helping the patient, you are causing it more harm. Right? So solutions are important. They are very, very important. Okay.
Sir, where do osmosis take place in a human body, sir?
Everywhere, every cell, all the time is doing the same thing.
Whole cells, in a whole body.
Oh, the whole body at all the time, osmosis, diffusion, solutions, all this are continuously happening. We don't realize the beauty of living system, right? All these phenomena we study in physics or chemistry are ultimately applied beautifully in biology, right? So to become a good biologist, you must become a good physicist, you must become a good chemist, and you must be a good mathematician. then only you can become a good biologist.
So we should be all rounder to be a good biologist.
Yes. Okay. I hope you enjoyed
yes,
and understood the concept of osmosis. Thank you for watching.
Thank you so much.